Hi everybody, we have three of my six Kirbys here, the two DS50s and the DS80 from Megadeth Player. The video is to mainly highlight the two new Kirbys, the DS80 and the DS50 on the left, my DS50 being the one on the right. Finally got the new DS50 back from the VAC store from a mild polishing and a fan replacement. It had a cracked fan. I think it's almost been a month since I brought it to him. I brought it to him almost after getting it from Megadeth Player to have him assess how expensive it would be for a fan. And I wasn't too fond of the price, but I figured get it over with now. By the time he's done with it, I'll have the money. Still don't have the money, but that was irrelevant. Paid for it anyway. Right off the bat, the bag that is on his DS50, which is the one in the middle, is what's supposed to be on mine, hence why mine doesn't have a bag on it. I'm short a bag because I can't find the emptor, or at least haven't done an in-depth search of my basement yet. Can't find the emptor for his. I swear I brought it and the bag, which is the one that's on the emptor that's on it right now, the appropriate Kirby DS50 bag. Brought that in the house to swap bags because they wanted the proper bag on my DS50. I was going to put the aftermarket replacement on his. And since it's been a month, either it's buried somewhere here within the vacuums, or somehow I think it ended up at the office in a crate of vacuum parts. But I got the bag here, so I'll find that, and that's still got to be polished, I'll bet, and put that on it. I think I'm going to bring his Kirby to the office for safekeeping right now because my vet guy said the Kirby has no place in a basement, and seeing I just put $45 in it, actually $53, to have him polish and clean it up, I think for safekeeping right now of the quality of the thing so it doesn't get all pitted again within the next few years, I'm going to put it at the office. My two, I'll just have to keep a handle on the stuff, polish them every once in a while or something. So now that all the technicals are out of the way, as I said, I brought it in about a month ago to get a fan done on it and have him polish it up a bit. Didn't exactly do the finest polishing job I've seen him do. Because he did a much better job on my DS80 when I brought that thing in for its full servicing. And he charged me $5 less, and he completely rebuilt the motor on that other one. But after having a conversation with him about how he polishes vacuums and such, he brought up the fact that he would generally charge almost right off the bat $250 to polish a Kirby, especially one with so many curves and stuff as the old ones. So I guess $40 or whatever his labor was, subtracted from the $53 for fan parts, I guess that's not too bad for doing a 3/4 S polishing on it. And we'll bring it up close and you take a look. A couple parts I would have liked to be a little better, you can see it, or he was real lazy around there. He didn't want to get close to it or anything. And there's a couple spots here where you could tell it really surfaced it good and then didn't do too good there. And I know for a fact he could have done the handle better because you still see some of the spotting in there and stuff on the front and the sides. The nozzle probably came out the best. I don't know if you can see it or not in the camera. And he probably could have done a little better in here, but I know that that's a pain in the butt curve there. And the underside of it, could have been better, but of course that's like a high detailing thing. For the most part, it definitely looks good, and I can't even remember what it looked like when I brought it to him. It was more than a month ago, but it's definitely better. For reference, the emptor was polished by me and the machine was polished by him, if you can tell the difference, so I can't complain. Only thing to do with this thing is if I buy some strange chance and miracle come across the appropriate cord for a very, 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 very cheap price, I will get that. Because what's on there is a brown cord that came with it. Whatever, Kirby had a brown cord. I never remember the colors. Never will. Unfortunately, this thing's cracked. but not much I can do about that. I also noticed the hood bumper is a different color on his. I'm more than positive mine is the appropriate color. Don't know why that one's a different color. Don't know any Kirby with that color bumper, nor that size. Maybe that came off a much older one. I'm not well versed in the 500 series colors. I know the Sanitronic 7 had the same color as the DS50. That's all irrelevant. Bumper is the same color. I can tell the nozzle bumper is the same color. I can tell that. What else? I don't know if I mentioned it, but the Kirby replacement DS50 cord I had on my DS80 went to this DS50, so now it has an appropriate cord. And I think on my DS50 I had that supposedly rare white and tan plugged cord from like a 512 or something, and that cord went to the Sanitronic 7. The Sanitronic 7 cord was that brown aftermarket replacement that's on the new DS80. And yeah, so what else was I gonna say? So yeah, the that bag and amp door that are on the new DS50 will be going back on mine as soon as this video is done. When I find the amp door for the new DS50, the aftermarket bag that was on that one is going on that one. For the DS80 to be original, and these of course the appropriate cord and the appropriate rear wheels, my DS50 will be all original with the exception of the dual front wheel thingy that it's got on it, but I like those, so that's staying. My DS80, I believe, is all original, except for the bag. Because my only option would be to put that bag on, and that bag is pretty worn out on that DS80, so I'm just going to stick with the aftermarket that's on mine. I don't know if you can tell the difference in polishing quality. That DS80 there looks good at first glance, but then when you compare it to the DS50s next to it, especially the one that was just polished, it gets blown out of the water, which is kind of funny. But, I mean, for my standards, I think it looks pretty good. It definitely isn't all spotted and dirty and crap like it was when I got it. And my DS50 could definitely stand a really good polishing on it, but I'm not spending any. I think it's not too bad. I mean, that I don't really know how that one ever got dirty or pitted or spotted or anything, as to do with time, especially in like a basement or something, because it was in a upstairs coat closet all its life, and my grandma took care of it, so I don't know. Another thing I was gonna mention, which was rather interesting, since I was there and conversing with him, I asked him what kind of buffer he uses, and apparently to do the real professional jobs like he did on my DS50 and my good DS80, need a really expensive buffer. He said the buffer he has was like a $600 buffer, and this thing spins so fast it like heats the metal up in seconds. And I'm like, oh, do you use that one for plastic? He said, try that buffer on plastic and it'll literally melt it with touching the thing. I'm like, oh, it's that fast. So apparently to do effective buffing on aluminum and such, you need a really, 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 really fast buffer. And the $20 buffing wheel I bought from Home Depot won't work either. That's what I thought most of the issue was, because my buffer only spins at 3,600 RPM, and I think my dad spins at 4,500, and his makes a big difference. And I bet if I put my soft buffing wheel on his, it would probably clean up a lot of other things nicely too. But I also found that my dad's buffer, which was the one that spins faster, but he has a slightly rougher wheel than my softest wheel. I have three different ones. I found out that his does a lot nicer of a job polishing plastic, and even on delicate stuff like elites and such, it doesn't even burn into the plastic like my medium grade wheel does. My softest buffing wheel takes a little push to get some of the deep marks out. Anyway, I'm kind of running on here, going on 10 minutes, so let's push the two Kirbys out of the way that aren't being ran and run the new DS50. Oh, I knew I was forgetting something. Not only did he have to replace the fan, he had to replace the plate, the bearing plate behind it, and the bearing. And I think he said, for the heck of it, while he had it apart and such, he did the back bearing too, because he said the front bearing was pretty much out, like going out. And to get the fan off, he had to pull the whole bearing plate and armature out too, because the fan wouldn't come off the armature. He thought he was going to have to replace the armature, because the fan wouldn't come off. It was so rusted on there. What he did was he drilled a little hole on the side of the fan right where the screws were for the bearing plate, and he just spun the fan around, took the screws out, pulled the whole armature out and everything, and then luckily was able to grab the armature and twist the fan off, put a new bearing plate, put a new bearing, put a fan on. As he said, while he had the armature out, he put a back bearing on the thing. So this thing's good to go. Heck, the motor in this one's probably in better shape than mine, because I've been told my grandma's DS50 has dry bearings. By sound, I think it sounds fine. I always thought it sounded fine. By sound, in that it needs bearings, but that's an expensive process. And but anyway, he said he uses a heavy duty steel rod or something to hold the armature through the little pinhole. And he said that my vacuum broke his steel rod. And I'm like, oh. Because I asked him, I said, yeah, what do you use to hold it? He's like, you mean, what did I used to use? I used to use a steel rod, but your vacuum broke it. Like, oops. And like, yeah, I was going to think to try a hammer punch, but I knew right away that thing was going to break. He's like, yeah, you would have busted that thing. I'm like, yep, that's why I left it to you. So, let's move these vacs out of the way, and we'll give the new Kirby a run. The new and improved Kirby. It's not new. It's been ran before, of course. So, in a rather lengthy video, pardon all my talking, there we have the newest DS50 all cleaned up and ready to put in the ranks. Hope you enjoyed it.